God.
You are God.
From beginning. Those hands together and bless the name of your Father. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, put those hands together. Come on, everybody. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeshua, Yeshua. So, so good, so good. Yes, you are, you are good. All the time, all the time. You are good, yeah.
You are good.
All the time, all the time. You are good, you are good. Oh, so good, yeah. One more time. You are good, you are good, you are good. Said you are. Greater one lives inside of me.
His name is Jesus.
I'm born a winner.
I'm born a winner.
Come on, somebody, come on.
More than victorious.
I'm the heir of this kingdom. Filled with love. I rejoice.
I rejoice.
I rejoice.
Wave your hands to him this morning and just give him praise. Raise your sound, raise your worship of God this morning. Let God hear him, you by himself this morning. Hallelujah. We bless you, Jesus. We exalt you. Aye, aye, aye. Yeah. We exalt you, Jesus. Aye, aye. You are bigger, bigger than what people say. You are greater than anything that comes my way. Your name, Jehovah, nobody can contend. Oh, I draw my leg, I'll be a sheep. You are bigger, bigger than what people say. You are greater than anything that comes my way. Your name is Jehovah. Nobody can contest. Boa toda me cabe. Hey, you are bigger, yeah.
Bigger.
You are greater, God. Your name is Jehovah. Nobody, nobody. Boa toda me. So we call you Kabi, yes you are. Yes you are, yes you are. Yeah. Kabi, yes you are. Yes you are, God. So I don't bother. We call you God, yes you are, yes you are, you are, you are, yeah, you are, you are, you are, yeah. Oh, you are bigger than what people would say. You are greater than anything that comes my way. Your name is Jehovah. Nobody can contest that. Yeah. We call you, you are bigger. Bigger than what we think you are. Yeah. And you are stronger than anything that comes my way. Your name is Jehovah. Nobody can contest Moadobale. Somebody raise your voice. Say you are big. Yes, you are. Hey, you are greater.
You are good, you are kind, you are nice. I have
seen it. I have known it. I can testify. You are good. You're amazing. 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 You are big. Bigger than what people call God. You are greater than anything that comes our way. Your name is Jehovah. Nobody can contest. No art of valor can be issued. You are big, bigger than what we can describe. You are God. You are greater than anything that comes our way. Yes, your name is Jehovah. Nobody can contest. No art of valor. Yeah. Can we hear the voice? You are big. You are greater than anything that comes away. Your name is Jehovah, yeah, yeah. Nobody can contest. No art of valor can be achieved. Can the Christ sing? Yeah, you are big.
You are
bigger than what we say. You are greater, God, than anything that comes out. Your name is Jehovah, yeah. Nobody
can contest.
Oh, what a valor, yeah. Happy days.
You are
bigger than what people say. Jehovah,
you're bigger than what people say.
You are bigger than what we call you. Jehovah,
you're bigger.
You are my song. You are king.
We acknowledge you, the great and mighty one, great in counsel and mighty deeds. Thank you, Father, for bringing us again to your presence. The second Sunday of the new year, 2023. You are glorious. You are marvelous. Heaven is your throne. The whole earth your footstool. Thank you, Father. You have kept us. You have delivered us. You have blessed us. So, Paluka Sota, Ia Makale Osh. We are grateful, oh Lord. We are thankful, Father. Thank you so much, oh God. Be thou exalted, oh Lord. Father, we exalt you. We magnify you, great and mighty God. Thank you, Father. We bless you, Lord. Our tomorrow, our beginning, and our ending. Thank you, Father. Man so tall, he gave us. We have brought our thanksgiving, O Lord. this morning, oh God, talk to you, oh God, because it is in you that we live and move and have our being. Thank you for your graciousness. Thank you for your mercy all through year 2022. And thank you now, oh Lord, you have begun the new year with us. It's a year of double portion. And we are grateful to you, O Lord. Be thou exalted, Emmanuel, now and forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Brethren, we have just begun a new year. There is therefore need for us to pray. Matthew 7:7 says, ask and it shall be given unto you. Ah, Father, we thank you for this congregation, Temple of God Church. Lord, we bless you, Lord. The theme for the year in Temple of God, it's a year of impact. Hallelujah. It's a year of impact. And when we talk about impact, it's about effectiveness. It's about relevance. It's about you giving the best that you can give to serve God, even in your various, in every aspect of your life. Our prayer point number one, therefore, shall be, the pastor, as senior pastor, before he left, in the first Sunday that he taught us, he mentioned that there are two types of impact. You either impact positively or you impact negatively. Every one of us standing before the presence of God has one thing or the other that you are doing. You are either a student, you are either a businessman, you are either a pastor, you are either a minister. And in every aspect of this, of your life, you need to make an impact. So lift up your voice this morning and say, Father, this year, like never before, help me to make impact in the mighty name of Jesus. It's a positive impact that I want to make, oh God, in my calling, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, as a trader, as a student, in my academics, oh Lord God Almighty, I want to make a relevant, I want to be relevant. It's about being effective. It's about being relevant. It's about showing that indeed, oh, you have, it's about your giftings and making good use of your giftings. Therefore, Lord, this year, oh God Almighty, as a church, oh Lord, we cry unto you, Father, that in every aspect of our lives, oh God, vocation, some of us are traders, ask God for ask him to help you to be able to make impact in that your shop, within your environment, in your community. The Bible says, let your light so shine. As a church, let our light continually shine, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in your family, you should make an impact. O God, this year, like never before, I want my light to shine. I want to be able to impact, O Lord, my community, my church, O God, as a mother, as a grandmother, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Use me for your glory, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Impact is adding value. What value do you want to add to yourself, to your environment, to your community, to your church, to your family, in your vocation, in your business, in ministry? What value do you want to add? Ask God to help you this morning in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I can't do it on my own. So God, I ask for help, oh Lord, to be able to make that relevance, that impact, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, to go the extraordinary, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, to make my light to shine. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, oh God Almighty, help me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Please quickly flip for me Genesis 49, verse 22. Genesis chapter 49, verse 22 of it. Thank you. The Bible says, Joseph is a fruitful bough. A fruitful bough by a well, his branches run over the world. That is impact. Praise the name of the Lord. Say, Father, this year, 2023, more than ever before, Make me relevant. Let me be fruitful in every aspect of my life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, I ask, O Lord God Almighty, as you helped Joseph, O God Almighty, help me too, O Lord, to be fruitful. The Bible says that Joseph, O Marike Suri Kataye Mashen Telebo, a fruitful vow. O Lord, make me this year that never before a fruitful bow. In the name of Jesus. A fruitful bough by a well that is flourishing. Impact is flourishing. Your giftings must show who you are in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, like never before this year. Oh God Almighty, you will make me fruitful in the name of Jesus. I shall profit for you. I shall profit as a mother. I shall profit as a grandmother. I shall profit as a servant in the house of the Lord. I shall profit in my academics. I shall profit even when I take new courses in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Our children, they shall profit for you, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, you will increase us and our families, O God. Make us this year. Give us the capacity, O God Almighty, to impact. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We ask for wisdom, because when we have wisdom, we were taught by our elder in the house, the King Iwayemi, our wisdom is so important. Bible says in Proverbs 4:7, wisdom. Can we display it, please? Proverbs 4:7 is one of my favorite scripture. It says, wisdom is the principal thing. For you to be able to be relevant, impactful, and effective, and be extraordinary in whatever you are doing, you need to ask for wisdom. Most of us here, maybe you are a student, ask for wisdom. Let's ask for wisdom. It's the principal thing. In that getting, you have to get understanding. I want us to pray for our children this morning in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That as Daniel was skillful and found better, 10 times better, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, our children, they are in school, oh Lord. Father, some of them in the universities, oh God Almighty. All of them that are pupils, that are students, oh God Almighty, we ask, oh Lord, for wisdom for them, oh God, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let them excel, oh God, in the academics, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Let them excel in their studies this year like never before, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And for us as elders, in Ecclesiastes 10:10b, it says wisdom is profitable for direction. Wisdom is profitable to direct. Let's pray. God, this year, in all our undertakings, you know, you need wisdom to navigate through year 2023. Can you lift up your voice and ask God, Father, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that wisdom, oh God, as an elder, oh Lord, in the mighty name of, as an adult, oh God, Father, I need wisdom, oh God, to navigate and excel in all my undertakings this year like never before, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Ask for that wisdom. It is profitable to direct, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Ask for that wisdom for your children, so that they can excel, be extraordinary, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Distinguished among their peers. Man so toli gabush and talibo so ndayaba. Oh Lord, I ask for wisdom, oh Lord, to profit for you, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We are going to pray for divine direction and guidance this year, to be able to navigate well and to be impactful, to be relevant, to be effective, to be outstanding. We need God. We need to ask God for divine direction and guidance. Psalm 37, verse 23. Please display quickly, the steps of the righteous. Man telebo shantayebo. Psalm 37, verse 23. It says, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his ways. We are going to cry to God the Father, that's, oh Lord, all through year 2023, order my steps. So, majakin shubu, majakin kose, in the mighty name of Jesus. I will not falter, I will not stumble, I will not fall, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Order my steps, oh God, in every everything that I do. You know all of my undertakings, our children in school, home and abroad, our grandchildren, oh God Almighty. Oh God, order their steps, oh God. We will have good report about them in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Our steps are ordered by you. Help us, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name. The Bible says in Proverbs 4:18, the path of the just is as a shining light that shineth more and more, even unto the perfect day. Oh God, in this year, oh God, 2023, in temple of God, as individuals, corporately, oh God, as families, oh God Almighty, lead and order our steps. So lead and direct and guide us all through. Order our steps, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's quickly pray. Committing the TOG church building project. It's about making impact, you know. It's about being relevant. It's about being productive. It's about profiting for God. We have a church project. Let's pray. Let's ask God for divine enablement, financial strength, and breakthroughs, favor and grace. Let God grant us, let God just prosper the works of our hands in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every one of you here will have to make a quota, a reasonable one, a contribution to making the building project a reality. Lord God Almighty, help us, oh God, as a church, oh God, to build, oh Lord, a befitting place of worship, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. This year, bless us financially like never before in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, help us, oh God, to make, oh Lord, the building, oh Lord, our own place of worship, oh God, a reality. Bless the works of our hands. Bless our finances, oh God. Bless every businessman. Bless every trader, oh God Almighty. Bless your people like never before so that we can build for you. Put money in our hands, oh God, like never before. Raise helpers, oh God, for this project for us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Finally, we are going to pray for Nigeria. The Bible says in Proverbs 21:1, Ezekiel 36:26, oh God Almighty, turn the hearts of our leaders in the mighty name of Jesus so that they can do what they are supposed to do for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Whether or not the elections are holding, it is important for us to pray that God will have his way in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Settle us this country like never before and direct and direct and direct and lead our leaders on the path that they should go. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. This might be an icing on your cake. In the mighty name of Jesus, can you prophesy upon yourself? Say, God, God spoke into existence this morning. Oh, Lord, begin to speak to your year 2023. Year 2023, I speak blessings according to the word of God in Proverbs 10:22. Your own blessing maketh rich. He added no sorrow. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak greatness. I speak all-round prosperity. Breakthroughs, joyous celebration, health, good health. Oh God, my finances, oh God Almighty, oh God Almighty, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, oh God, will be blessed more than never before. I'll be successful in all my undertakings this year. There is progress, there is advancement in the mighty name of Jesus. There is fruitfulness and there is safety for us in Jesus mighty name we have prayed. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless you. We cover all our prayers in the blood of Jesus. Continue with us in this service in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we ask, oh Lord, that Father, our senior pastor and his wife who are currently away, that Father, you keep them where they are. And oh Lord God Almighty, you bring them safely, oh God. Spirit, soul, and body, sound, oh God, back to us, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, even as you continue with us, we give you all the glory. Everyone will go, oh God, blessed, oh God, and edified. In Jesus' precious and wonderful name we pray.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's time to receive our offering. Let's package our offering and let's package our tithes. Shall we rise? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's give our dancing offering.
Hallelujah.
As we draw the offering.
Let's receive our offering.
All around,
and all of us have tithes in the house, please. You can come and drop your tithes.
The love is all around. Hey. Oh, all around, everywhere I look, your love is all around,
all around, everywhere I look, your love is all around,
all around,
all around, everywhere I look, your love is all around.
I will sing of your goodness, sing of your kindness, sing of your love and your grace. My Lord, you are good. You are good. Oh, I will sing. Your love and your grace. Yes, you are good. Oh, sing, I will sing. Sing of your goodness, of your kindness. Yes, you are good. You are good. You are good, Lord. One more time, I will sing.
I will sing,
Lord. I'll dance, Lord. I'll sing and you. Oh, my Lord, you are good. You are good. You are good. You are good. Oh, sing, I will sing, Lord.
Sing
of your goodness, of your kindness.
Let's set forth our hands to the offering. Our Father and our God, we thank you for your greatness in our life. Thank you for your mercies that endureth forever. Thank you for making our hands to prosper. Out of the abundance that you have given unto us, we have returned unto you a token. Father, accept us in the name of the Father and of the Son, and that of the Holy Ghost. Father, accept our offering as well, in the name of Jesus. Father, we sanctify this offering in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and that of the Holy Ghost. We ask that, Lord, that you will multiply it, you will increase it in billion and trillion folds, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we remember those who are complying with your directive as to tithes. We ask that, Lord, that you will open the windows of heaven for them in the name of Jesus. So much so that their room will not be able to contain, in Jesus' name. Thank you, our Father and our God. Thank God, because we thank you again, because you are going to use it for the extension of your work, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Jesus' mighty name we do pray. Hallelujah. Let's give a clap offering unto our God. Please help me welcome somebody by your right and your left. You are welcome to your father's house. Tell the person you are welcome to your daddy's house. It's your house. It's your father's house. You're welcome in the name of Jesus. We also take this time to welcome all who are worshiping with us for the first time. If today is your first time to worship with us, I just want you to wave by your hands if you are here. Thank you, Jesus. You're welcome, my brother. You're welcome, my brother. You're welcome,
welcome
my brother.
Welcome to the family of love, where the water can never cease.
Step up.
This is Step Up, God. There's no church without you. That's the truth.
Such an honor
to have you here.
This is Step Up.
This is Step Up, God.
We love you.
Yes, we do.
You are welcome once again in the name of Jesus. You are welcome to a solution place, a word place, a worship place, and God is here. After today, you are no longer a visitor to this place. You are part and parcel of this place. We praise the Lord for your life. And we thank God that God who has brought you will make you to prosper in the name of Jesus. As you have come, you will not return back empty in the name of Jesus. We also want to take this time to welcome those who are worshiping with us online. You're also welcome. And please make it your point of duty to tune to us as you join us on our various social media handles. God bless you. At the end of the service, please, all of you that worshiping with us for the very first time, please, you need to come to the front so that then the senior pastor will meet with you and welcome you properly. Praise the Lord. Our weekly services, we have the workers' fellowship from 8 a.m. to 8:30 on a Sunday morning like this. From 8:30 to 9 a.m., we have the Sunday school. I think this is the one that we just finished. And the family service, if it is the service that you are in now, and it starts from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Also, we have a virtual services for assisting and aspiring professionals from 11 a.m. Please join us by Zoom so you can join us from 11. Praise the Lord. On Tuesdays, we have our Bible study online from 6 p.m. in the evening. This you can join from our Facebook page, the YouTube channel as well. Please join us on Tuesday for Digging Deep. On Thursdays, our prayer meeting, normally also at 6 p.m. via Zoom as well. So please join us on Thursdays for prayers. Good news. When God wants to do something big, He always starts with us with very good news. RCCG 50 days prayer and fasting. Hallelujah. Why are you laughing? Isn't that a good news? Only 50 days. Hallelujah. We are going to commence this fasting this Wednesday on the 11th. Hallelujah. Why are you quiet? Praise the Lord. Let's give a clap offering unto our God. Fasting is not going to kill us. It's going to make us alive. Hallelujah. So let's key into it. It's 50 days. We are kicking off on Wednesday, January 11. Again, because it's prayer and fasting, we will be meeting online. prayers from 5:30 to 6 p.m. Just 30 minutes, just to break the fast. From 5:30 every day. So from Wednesday, there will be a continuous prayer around the clock from 5:30 p.m. to 6:30 throughout the fasting period. Members are encouraged to participate. And you know what? This year in the Redeemed Christian Church of God, everything that you are going to get, you are not going to get it once. You are going to get a double portion. Hallelujah. So for every day that you fast, you will receive double reward already. So please bear that in mind. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Let's clap for Jesus. I'm not getting the vibes that we are ready to do it. Hallelujah. But you know that you can do all things. You know what? You can do through. Hallelujah. So let's hang that. Let's stay on that side. We will do it. Amen. Today is our pastor's birthday, Pastor Yomi Owoeye. I know he's not here. For us that knows him, so we're going to pray for him. He's not here, but he's there. Today is his birthday. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just want to thank you for your son. We raise him unto you. Not only him, everyone that is celebrating his birthday that we don't even know that in this church, we commend them unto you. Who is able to keep, who is able to uphold. Lord God, as they go into this new year, Lord God, you will go ahead of them in the name of Jesus. Lord, we will prosper their way this month, this year, as they go in the name of Jesus. It's a new year. It's a new dawn for them. Lord, you will make everything new for them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we do pray. Just to also let you know that there will be a counselor. This is to inform all members that there will be a counselor available at the end of every service, even like today. And it's totally free at the back of the church. If you want counseling, spiritual or otherwise, please, the counselor will be available at the back of the church, at the junior church, after the service. Please make use of the service. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless us as we continue with the service in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's celebrate Jesus. Someone celebrate Jesus. Hallelujah. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. We'll be taking our hymn this morning before the choir ministration. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. So you can look behind. There's a hymn book, hymn 30. And please, shall be up standing. Hymn 30, page 13. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Amen. We can be comfortably seated. Hallelujah. This morning we have the choir have a song, Wonderful Savior. It's a very common song, and we ask that, we pray that even as we minister, may we be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.
Whoa.
our feet as we worship God.
Of my melody, you are all the matters, you are all the matters. I make room for you and not Jesus. You are all the matters, you are all the matters, yeah. You are all, yeah. You are all, yeah. I make room for you. You and I, Jesus. You are all the matters. You are all the matters. I put you in front of my melody. You are all, you are all, you are all, you are all, yeah. I make room for you. You and I, Jesus. You are all, you are all. Yes, you are all. Ooh. You are all the matters. You are all the matters.
Through 2023, help us to put you in front of us. Help us to put what you have said in front of us. As we go through this year, help us on a daily basis to make room for you in our thoughts, in our decisions, in our going out, in our coming in everything that we do, wherever we go, help us to make room for you. Father, what matters is not what we can see. What matters is not what we can hear. What matters is what you have to say. And so we put you in front of us this year. Lead us aright, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. You may have your seat.
the Lord. I don't know why I'm so excited about this year. I'm truly, truly excited about 2023. Because I know it's going to be a great year. What matters is what God has to say. What matters about this year is what God has to say. Not what I see, not what I think, not what I feel, but what God has to say. And God has assured me it's going to be a great year. And it shall be in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 5, verse 14 to verse 16. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand. And it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Praise the Lord. This morning we are looking at let your light shine, and our light shall shine in Jesus' name. Jesus, when he's telling his disciples, and by extension you and I, that we are the light of the world, he says something. He starts and he wants them to understand something, that you need to know who you are. And this year, truly, we need to know who we are. You need to know who you are before your light can shine. Now, I don't know how many of us have ever attended an interview, maybe for a job, or you have been on a panel interviewing people for a job. And many a times they would ask you that, tell us about yourself. Have you ever been at such an interview? Because they want to feel your pulse. They want to know the kind of person you are. But Jesus turns the table around. Now, when you want to know who a person is, don't even ask the person anything about who he is. Don't ask even the closest person that, who is this person? Who you are. And we need to first understand this if our light is going to shine. Who you are is not who you think you are. Who you are is not who you say you are. Who you are is not what people say you are or think about you. Who you are is who God says you are. And he says you are the light of the world. So that's the starting point to making impact. That is the starting point to your light shining. That I first need to know, who am I before I can even make any impact? Who am I before my light can shine? And Jesus says, you are the light of the world. He says that you are somebody important. If light should go off now in this service, we know what's going to happen. First of all, we'll be in darkness. Next thing, mics, everything will go off. This service, it would, you know, be adversely affected. Light makes things happen. And Jesus says, you are somebody that you make things happen. Jesus says that you are somebody that you have value, you have worth. You know how we use light. We are charging our phone. You wake up, you are charging your phone. You charge your laptop, your iPad. You use light for your fan, air conditioner, practically everything we do. Plants need light to grow. Animals need light. We need light. And when there's no light, even if it's cold, just because there's no light, already your body just starts adjusting and you become uncomfortable. And Jesus says, you are the light of the world. You are useful. You are important. You add value. So that is a starting point. That's why Jesus first says that you are the light of the world. He didn't ask them that, who are you? Tell me about yourself. He didn't go and ask those closest to them, who is this person? He says that who you are is who I say you are. And so if we're going to make impact, go and discover, who are you? Don't ask your husband or your wife, who am I? Don't ask yourself. Don't look at your past. Don't look at your mistakes and tell yourself, this is who I am. Go and find out, who does God say you are? And that is who you are. And so he says, you are the light of this world. You are a person that is useful. You are a person that has worth. You are a person that has value. You are a person that makes a difference. You make things happen. So that when those dark days come and you begin to feel unworthy, you begin to feel worthless. You begin to feel like, what am I even doing in this world? It's now 2023. Eh? This is how the years are just coming and going. No change in my life, no difference. When discouraging thoughts start coming, you put what God says before you, in front of you, I am the light of the world. So that those discouraging thoughts, they don't graduate to depressing thoughts, then they graduate to suicidal thoughts. Towards the end of last year, I mean, when I've been hearing this thing about suicide, 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 sometimes you just think it's, you know, when things are so far away from you, you don't know how real they are. And towards the end of last year, I took my son William to a barber who stays just, you know, close to our street. The following week, my husband was like, did I hear what happened? I said, what happened? He said that that guy has committed suicide, that he killed himself, hung himself, locked himself in his room, and people didn't know till that whole place started smelling. And when they opened it, they saw that he had killed himself. We need to know who you are. You can't make impact if you don't know who you are. Because if you don't know who you are, who God says you are, when thoughts of discouragement will come, when they will now want to grow into depression, into suicide, if you don't know who you are, you can't make impact. And God is telling somebody today, if you didn't know it before, you make things happen. You add value. You are a person of worth. You are relevant. You are significant. Praise the Lord. For our light to shine, Jesus also says something. He says that when you put light, you don't put it under a basket. You put it on a lampstand. That elevation is very important to light. Praise the name of the Lord. So let's do a quick experiment in this room that we're in. When you live here, to really understand what Jesus is saying, when you are on the streets, when you are in your house, when you are in your office, when you go to places, look at what I'm saying. So let's do a quick experiment in this room. How many sources of light can we see? How many lights can you see here? There's one up there. We have these lights here. We have the ceiling lights. Where are all of them positioned? Jesus says that for light to be bright, for light to be visible, for light to be effective, for light to have impact, light has to be elevated. You don't put light under. You elevate the light. And so as you go out, just check the street light, office light, the lights in your house, they are all put on an elevated platform. And so for you to make impact, you first know, who am I? I add value. I make a difference. I'm a person of worth. Then go and elevate yourself. Place yourself in a strategic position. And what is a strategic position to be placed in? Jesus Christ. He's the highest pinnacle. He's the highest point. He's the highest level. The highest point is not that I want to be the chairman, yes, that's good, of an organization. The highest point is not I want to be an MD, that's good, or the president. The highest peak anybody can attain in life is to be positioned in Christ Jesus. Am I communicating this morning? Philippians 2 verse 9 tells us that his name is exalted above every other name. Ephesians 2 verse 6 says that he's seated in heavenly places. Ephesians 1 verse 21 says he's seated far above every power, every ruler, every name. So Jesus is on the highest level. So if I'm going to make impact like light, I need to be elevated. I need to be standing on the highest point that I can stand. And the highest point anybody can stand is when you are standing in Christ. So what is Jesus telling us? That our relationship with him is key if we are going to make impact, if we are going to make a difference. That you need to be rooted in Christ. You need to be standing in Christ. You need to be elevated in Christ. You need to be standing, seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. That is where he has positioned us. Because light that is not elevated really doesn't make much difference. And the funny thing is that even in this room, if you check on the floor, there's actually light put on the floor. But you know the light they put on the floor, do you know what it does? It's for effects. It's for a fizzy. It's the thing that is bringing out those colorful lights you see. But light that is for vision, to see, to make a difference, is elevated. Praise the name of the Lord. So you can decide that I just want to be for effects. I just want to be for a fizzy in my walk with God. You know, I just want to be somebody that people see me, oh, you look nice, you do this, you do that. But if I want to make impact, a difference, I will get elevated. This morning, God is saying, get elevated. Go higher with Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. What is the essence of light? Jesus says that you don't bring light and you put it under a basket, that you put it on a lampstand, that it gives light to all who are in the house. Praise the name of the Lord. So the whole essence why we even want light is for what? It's so that we'll have light. It's just simply that so that we will see. So when you are going to buy light bulbs, fluorescent bulbs, spotlights, floodlights, all the kind of lights, solar lights, the whole thing you want is that you just want to see. Now, have you seen some streets? They have street lights, but those street lights have never come on. You pass that street every day, and street lights are there, but the light is never on. They don't work. So they are not serving any purpose. And Jesus says that, what's the point of bringing light if you are going to put it under? If it's not going to light up the room? If it's not going to give light to everybody? And Jesus is saying that, what is the essence? Now we should sit down and think, what's the whole point of He coming into our lives? He giving us light. He coming in and bringing the light of God into us. And we're not giving light. That was the whole point, the whole essence of I saying I'm a believer. And I'm not even an example for people to follow. I'm not an example of what a godly mother is, a godly father, a godly spouse. People can't look at me and say that this is an example of a dedicated worker, a disciplined worker. This is an example of somebody with character, with integrity. Then there's no whole point in Jesus coming to our life if we are not giving light. I hope I'm communicating. You go for light. When you are going to look for light bulb or you are sending somebody for light bulb, it's because you want to see. You want to have light. And Jesus is saying, if we are the light of the world, there is no point of Him being in our life. We calling ourselves believers and we are not giving any light. We are not using what He has put in us to impact, to make a difference, to be a blessing. We are not using our gifts to impact. We are not using our resources to impact. We are not using our talents to impact. We are not using everything that He has deposited in us to bless people, to impact lives. Praise the name of the Lord. God will help us to shine. God will help us to make a difference. Praise the name of the Lord. The other thing Jesus says about light is that light can be hidden. Luke chapter 8, verse 16. Let me read it again from verse 15 of our text, Matthew 5, verse 15. It says that, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all who are in the house. Praise the Lord. Luke 8, verse 16. Can we have that? Luke 8, verse 16. No one, when he has lit a lamp, covers it with a vessel or puts it under a bed, but sets it on a lampstand that those who enter may see the light. So light can actually be there, but it's being covered. It's being hidden. That's another thing Jesus wants us to understand, that if you are the light of the world, don't let anything cover your light. Don't let anything hide your light. And what are those things that cover our light? The first thing that covers our light is our mindset. What you think, that's why we started from knowing who you are. What you think about yourself, it can limit you. It can cover your light. It can hide your light. Praise the name of the Lord. So God goes to somebody like Moses and He tells him that you are going to go out to Egypt and you are going to deliver the Israelites. And He begins to tell him, but they are not going to believe me. I don't speak very well. I'm not eloquent. I'm slow of speech. And he goes telling God all kinds of excuses. So what you think about yourself can dim your light. And you know the thing about Moses was that when he kept on telling God, God is saying, oh, I'm going to use you. You are going to do this. And he said, I can't talk. I can't this. I can't that. Okay, try somebody else. And that was what God did. He now brings Aaron. So when God is saying that you are the light of the world, I want to use you. I want to make you to make an impact. He sees all our limitations. He knows those of us that can't talk very well. He knows those of us that we think I'm too fat, I'm too slim, I don't come from a rich home, I don't come from a good background. He sees all of that and he's coming and he's telling you that you are the light of the world. Meaning that what you are is not important in his hands. It is your yielded self that is important to God. Am I communicating with God? With us? It is us yielding ourselves and we start making impact. We start making a difference. So if our light is going to shine, we should not limit ourselves. We need to renew our mind. And that was why the Israelites, when God told them that, go into Canaan, that you are going to conquer the land, you are going to take over that land. And they go and they are like, I can't take over that land. I'm not able. And God is saying, you can do something. And you are telling God, I can't do it. And God is saying, you can do it. And we're arguing with God, I can't do it. I can't do it because in that land, there are giants. But God saw those giants and he says, you can conquer them. Praise the name of the Lord. So if we're going to make impact, we need to renew our mind. We need to renew our mind from those limitations of, I can't make a difference. I can't make an impact because I'm either somebody that, you know, I'm not rich enough. I don't really have what it takes, or what I even have cannot make a difference. It's like the boy that gave his 5 loaves and 2 fish. Just like this morning, Mommy, Pharaoh Timmy was praying about building projects. I'm sure when Pastor Ewaimi comes again, he'll talk about building project. And we hear it every day. And many of us, once we just hear that thing about building project, we switch off. Because we're like, this building project, not people like me they are talking of. Is it my 2,000? Is it my 5,000? So we just immediately, we switch off. Because we believe it's not for me. And like when that boy gave his 2 fish and 5 loaves, I know that there'll be many people, some children, they are all not giving was because you know some children are greedy, they don't like sharing. So when the disciples were going around asking who has anything, some they just hid their 10 biscuits and wafer because they didn't want to share. And there were those that would have been like, but all I have is just 5 biscuits, all I have is 10 wafers. See all these people, what's my 10 biscuits going to do? And they hid it. The boy we're talking about today is the one that made impact because he felt whatever I have, whatever contribution, I hand it over to God. Am I communicating with us? So if we're going to make impact, it's not about who you are. It's not about what you have. It's about yield yourself to God. If it's only that 2,000 you have, yield it to God. If it's only that 5,000, yield it to God. If all you know how to do is you just know how to talk, you talk, you talk, you talk, and it's like people are like, when will you just keep quiet? Take that talking to God. Praise the name of the Lord. And when you give him what you have, he can use you to make an impact. Praise the name of the Lord. So we shouldn't allow human limitations limit us. Praise the name of the Lord. The only thing that makes us hide our light, that makes us cover our light, Acts 9, 26, verse 27. Can we have that quickly? Acts 9, 26 to 27. And when Saul had come to Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him and did not believe that he was a disciple. You know, one of the things Paul had to fight and conquer was people's perception of him, people's opinion of him. And when he became a believer, the disciples, they didn't believe that this man was truly born again. And he had to conquer people's perception, people's opinion about him, that you are a fake, you are not sincere, you are coming with a hidden agenda. And he conquered it, and his light was shining. Many of us, we are not able to conquer people's perception about us. Am I communicating? People's opinion about you. If your light is going to shine, so somebody tells you that you are useless. Somebody tells you that nothing good can come out of you. Somebody tells you that that idea is not going to work. Nobody is going to buy it. People tell you things. And God is saying, you need to see yourself as who I say you are. Not what people are saying about you. People were saying about Paul, he's a fake. He's not sincere. He has a hidden agenda. He's going to come out and kill us after all of this. He had to conquer all of that and make impact. If we're going to make impact in 2023, whatever people are saying about you, God is saying, put it in one corner. Put it behind you. What you should put in front of you is who I say you are. Somebody that makes a difference. Somebody that adds value. Somebody that is important. Somebody that makes things happen. Praise the name of the Lord. So if our light is going to shine, let's not allow human limitations cover it. Let's not allow people's perception, people's opinion about us cover it. For our light to shine, let's not allow challenges of life cover it. I can imagine somebody like Joseph. And I know that, I mean, if it's somebody like me, I'm sure that's the same thing I would have done. When your own blood brothers, they throw you into the pit, I would have first cried and cried and cried and cried inside that pit. I would cry and wonder and cry and wonder and cry and wonder and cry and wonder. You see, what Joseph did, sometimes when you read about these things, you need to put it in your own practical everyday life. Truly, many of us, your own blood brother throws you into a pit. To even come out of that pit, you will first have, you know, you go into, your head will start paining you. You'll be like confused. You'll be worried. You'll be like, what is all this? That's not enough. They sell you. And you're like, my own, this one is not adopted brother. This one is not, family friend. My own brother selling me. But Joseph conquered all of that. He didn't allow challenges of life, problems of life. He didn't allow any trial of life cover his light, dim his light. And so they take him as a slave. He's in Potiphar's house. Many of us, if we were in Potiphar's house, every day as we're sweeping, as we're cleaning, we'll be frowning, we'll be squeezing our face, we'll be, this kind of life, I'm the only one, this, that, you know. As he was there sweeping, he was there cleaning, he was there doing everything, and light was just shining. They were seeing somebody making a difference, somebody making an impact, and that was how Potiphar elevated him. Then his wife comes, tells a horrible lie about him. They arrest him for something he didn't do. Many of us, when time they arrest us, the whole world will hear. We'll shout in that prison. We'll do everything. We'll make a whole lot of noise. We'll get depressed. Am I communicating with us? Joseph is thrown into prison for something he didn't do. And even there, his light is shining. The prison warden puts him in charge. So if our light is going to shine, yes, 2023 will come with blessings, but it would also come with trials. It will come with difficult times. If your light is going to shine, that means that no matter the difficulty, no matter the trying times, no matter the affliction, no matter the trials, I will keep shining for the Lord. I will keep making impact. Praise the name of the Lord. I will make impact if I'm in the pit. I will make impact if I'm thrown as a slave. I will make impact if I'm in prison. I will make impact the day I have money. I will make impact the day I don't have money. Because some of us, the day we don't have our money, the whole world will know. Everybody will know. It will be on our face. It will be everywhere we go. To praise the Lord, we can't praise the Lord. To shout hallelujah, we can't shout hallelujah. If you are going to make impact, the day you don't have money, you are making impact, you are shining. The day people are saying all kinds of things about you, you are still shining. The day you are going through difficulties, health challenges, you are still shining. You are not allowing anything and anyone get to you. That is how our light can shine. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord will give us grace in Jesus' name. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. If our light is going to shine, then we're not going to allow the devil cover our light. One thing Satan tries to do is to bring temptation and sin our way to cover our light. Because sin has a way of making people hide. When Adam and Eve sinned against God, Genesis 3 verse 10 says that they went and they hid themselves. When we're not living right, when we fall into sin, it covers our light. It makes us hide. This morning, Pastor Ewemi was telling us about setting goals for the year. And if our light is going to shine, one of the goals we should set is that, okay, what are my besetting sins? Because James 4 verse 7 says, if you don't resist the devil, there's no way he's going to leave you. If you don't resist him, if you are just friends with him, you are just, whatever he's doing, you are looking at it, he will keep coming. He will keep coming with sexual temptation. He will keep coming with financial temptations. He will come with all kinds of temptations, all kinds of things to bring us down. But when we make up our mind that, okay, this year, this lying must stop. This immorality must stop. This stealing must stop. This backbiting must stop. And you now say, Satan, I resist you. I take a stand against these temptations you have been bringing my way to bring me down. He will flee. Because that's what the word of God says. But if we just continue entertaining those temptations and allowing him cover our light, we cannot shine. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Job chapter 2, verse 5. Can we have Job 2, verse 5? But stretch out your hand now and touch his bone and his flesh, and he will surely curse you to your face. Praise the name of the Lord. So the devil will come with temptation to cover your light. He will come with satanic attack. And here he explained that the whole essence why he was going to attack Job was so that he will affect Job's relationship with God, so that he will curse God, so that he will no longer be close to God. And so when Satan is attacking, all he's aiming for is that he wants to dim our light. He wants to cover our light. He wants to make it impossible for us to be with God, to serve God, to love God, to make a difference. But this year, God is saying, when he throws his arrow at you, let it backfire. When he sends his agents to you, you have the power, you have the authority. Use the Holy Ghost fire to send them away. Because all he's trying to do is to cover your light, to dim your light, to make you not make impact. Praise the name of the Lord. We are going to resist the devil this year. Satan will not cover my light. He will not cover your light. He will not dim my light. He will not dim your light. And we have everything inside of us to resist him from covering our light in Jesus' name. As we begin to round up and we go into prayer, Matthew chapter 5, 14 to verse 15. Can I have it in Message translation? Matthew 5, 14 in Message translation. Do you have that? Here's another way to put it. You are here to be light, bringing out the God colors in the world. God is not a secret to be kept. We are going public with this. As public as a city on a hill. The truth of the matter is that if you don't go public with your faith, if you don't go public with your relationship with God, your light is not going to shine. And that's what that scripture is saying. That's the whole essence of Matthew 5, that we should stop this secret Christianity where it is only in church people know we are Christians, where it is only in church people know us as prayer warriors, that we should stop living secret Christianity. Go public with your faith. Publicize it to the world that you are a believer. Publicize it with your life, you are a believer. You know, I keep listening to it over and over again. Sissy Winans Believe concert. Because going public with your faith is not only about when you get a megaphone and you go to Lekki bus stop. If that is what God has told you to do, there's a divine instruction on your life to do it, it's fine. But going public with your faith, she was saying that there was a time her brother died, and the doctor came to meet them, and he told her whole family was there, and the doctor came and he said that they've lost their brother. And the father said, can we pray for you? That's to the doctor. That can we pray for you and go back and try again? And the doctor looks at them as in, well, if that's what you want. And so they pray for the doctor. And the doctor goes back, and the next thing they hear, that the brother that the doctor came and said, you've lost your brother, he has died. They heard the brother was in recovery. What am I saying about going public with our faith? Is that in everyday situations, somebody is sick, somebody is confused, somebody doesn't know what to do. Many of us are still secretive about God. We can't open up and say, can I pray for you in that situation? We can't open up and say, this is what God says about the situation. We are so secretive about the fact that we are Christians. And we think our light can shine. It can make any difference. It can be visible to anybody. So we do that because we want a hidden agenda where I can be a Christian in church and outside I can do anything I like. Am I communicating with us? We want that hidden covering and agenda that I can be a Christian in church, and when I go outside, I can be practically naked outside because nobody knows I'm really a Christian. We have a hidden agenda that I can be a Christian inside church, but because of the bribes I take in my office, let that Christianity end here. And the Message Bible puts it so clear that go public, publicize it. Let them know in your office that you are a believer. You are ordering for cake for your child's birthday. Let a conversation, it's just cake, but let a conversation that will come out from you, let people know you are a believer. Somebody is sick in your office. You are a believer. You are in the choir. You are an usher. You are an elder. The person is sick, and the first thing that comes to your mind is, have you taken malaria medicine? I didn't say medicine is wrong. Don't miss me. But how are people going to see this light? When it's a secretive light, when every day and in every situation that comes our way, nobody hears about God. Nobody knows what God can do. Nobody knows the difference he can make. Praise the name of the Lord. Can we rise to our feet this morning? You need to go public. We need to publicize it. He says that you are the light of the world, that you don't put light under a table. You elevate the light. You need to go public. You need to elevate yourself in Jesus Christ and let people know what you stand for, who you are, that you are a Christian, that it doesn't matter what they think about you. Like Paul, people may be saying he's fake. Like Paul, people may be saying you have a hidden agenda. That's not your business. Jesus says you are the light of the world. And you go out and you let people see that light. You let people hear about that light. You hear people know about that light. Are you here this morning? He says that if you acknowledge me before men, Matthew chapter 13, if you acknowledge me before men, I will acknowledge you. That is that if you can publicize me, if you can come out and let people know that you are a believer, the way I will honor you before men, it will be shocking. Are you here today? You are not born again. John 8 verse 12, Jesus says, I'm the light of the world, and whoever walks in me will not walk in darkness. You want to step out of the darkness. Darkness of sin, darkness of satanic oppression, darkness of failure, darkness of depression, darkness of feeling I'm a nobody, darkness of feeling I'm not good enough, darkness of feeling I don't make a difference. You want to come fully into the light and be who Christ says you are. Can you come forward? Anybody, you want to surrender your life to God today? Let's do that very quickly. If there's anybody here, you are saying, I give my life to you, Lord Jesus. I want to walk with you in 2023. I want to live for you in 2023. I want to follow you. I want to honor you. Anybody else, we are going to pray. If you know you want to give your life to Jesus today, he says, go public with it. Don't look around and be ashamed. If you are making that decision, can you come out very quickly? And let us pray for you. In Jesus' name, can you repeat after me? Lord Jesus, my brother, I'm talking to you. Can you repeat the prayer? Lord Jesus, I've acknowledged you before men. Accept me into your fold. Don't let me go back into my sin. Don't let me go back into darkness. Write my name in the book of life and let my name remain there forever. Help me to walk with you. Help me to live for you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Please, can you follow? The usher will direct you to the sister over there. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise Jesus. Can we take that song one more time, choir? I put you in front of me. As we're taking that song, let your prayer be, Lord. Sorry, can we? As we're taking that song, your prayer is this. Today, I put aside my thinking about myself. All the negative thoughts I have about myself, I put it aside. What people have said about me, I put it aside. What I'm going through right now, I put it aside. The problems before me, I put it aside. The challenges before me, I put it aside. Anything that can take your place in my life, I put it aside. And I put you right in front of me. Let's take that song to God. Can we all worship God with that song?
I put you in front, front of my melody. You were all the matter. You were all the matter. I make room for two, you and I, Jesus. You were all the matter. Yes. You were all the matter. You were all the matters, yeah. You were all the matters, yeah. I make room for you and I, Jesus.
To tell him that, Father, everything covering and dimming my light, remove it now. Every sin covering and dimming my light, remove it now. Satan, I rebuke you. Hands up my life, hands up my destiny. Every satanic attack, every satanic arrow on my health, on my finances, to cover my life, I rebuke you, Satan. Every weakness, every limitation covering my light, I rebuke you. I cast you aside. Every weakness covering my light, I lay you aside. I receive strength from God. I receive strength from God. Everything, anyone covering my light, hiding my life, I remove you. I cast you off. I strip you off. Everything, anyone hiding my life, covering my life, not making me make impact, not making me make a difference, I remove you. I strip you off. 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 In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, oh God, for your word of life to us this morning. Father, we thank you because we are who you say we are. You say that we are the light of the world. Our light shall not be covered in the name of Jesus. Our light shall not be put under the table in Jesus' name. We shall not be like salt that has lost its flavor and people are trampling over us. We shall go out and make a difference. We shall go out and shine for you. No challenge of life, no trouble of life will dim our light in the name of Jesus. We have come to you to receive strength. Strength to shine. Strength to make a difference. Strength to make impact. From today, oh God, my life makes impact. My life adds value. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah. Before we take our seat, can we just stretch our hands to Pastor Tesh and pray for her? Virtue has gone out of her. Pray that the Lord will anoint her afresh with his Holy Ghost and with his power. That the Lord will strengthen and reinforce her with mighty power. In Jesus' name. Pray that it shall be well with her ministry, it shall be well with her husband, her children, and her work. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Father, refresh your daughter. Anoint her afresh with your Holy Ghost and with your power. Lord, strengthen and reinforce her with mighty power in Jesus' name. Perfect all that concerns her and let it be well with her and her family in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. You can have your seat, please. Glory be to God. Yes, as Pastor Tesh mentioned, and also Pastor Faro Timi, we need to talk about the building project. We're all aware of it. Technical, can you project it? The land that we are here, this land where we are, is leased. It's a leased land, and our lease will soon run out. That's why we need to acquire a new land where we'll build our permanent a permanent parish, a permanent site for our parish. And the building committee has made it easy. You don't have to wait until you have plenty of money. No. We want everybody to be a part of it. So whatever you have, bring it. We'll accept it. 500 naira, 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000. 100,000, 200,000, 1 million, 10 million, any amount you have, bring it. So you'll be a part of it. So everybody is expected to contribute and be a part of it. This morning we're talking about planning your year. So as you plan for your year, as you plan your offering for the year, also include your contribution towards the building project. So you can earmark a certain amount for the building project every week or every month. And that will make it easy for you than to wait until you have plenty of naira. Praise the Lord. That's the account that is being on the screen. It's being projected on the screen. We also have another account with Heritage Bank. So you can use any of the two accounts. And you can see our sisters at the welcome desk. They will give you the other account if you need it, or use this one. So any amount you have, bring it. You have to be a part of what the Lord is doing. Praise the Lord. So everybody is expected to be a part of it. Praise the Lord. The Lord will help you. The Lord will empower you. The Lord will meet all of your needs. He will give you abundance this year. You will not lack in any good thing. And it shall be well with you, spirit, soul, and body, in Jesus' name. You know, once you plan and you commit your plan to God, God will help you to bring that plan to pass. That's why it's good to set it aside and say, okay, this year, this is how much I plan to give towards the building project. Set aside an amount. Dream a bigger amount that you know that ordinarily you will be able to do. Something much more than you can do ordinarily. And give it to God. God will help you to fulfill and to bring your plan to pass. Hallelujah. Now we had during the announcement that we'll be starting the 50 days fast on Wednesday, 11th of January. So there will be prayers every evening from Wednesday, from 5:30 to 6 p.m. And it will be online. So there will be online prayers. So please join us. The link will be sent. I believe every one of us is on one platform in the church. Either the men, the women, the youth, the workers, the ministers. You must be a part. You must belong to one platform. So the link will be there. Just check it every evening, 5:30 to 6 p.m. There will be online prayers until March 2nd, when the fasting will end. Praise the Lord. Okay, can we rise up as we close the service and let us pray? Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18. Can we see Proverbs 4, 18? Proverbs 4, 18. No, let's see the New Living or the NKJV. The way of the righteous is like the first gleam of dawn, which shines ever brighter until the full light of day. Let's see the New King James Version. Yes, but the path of the just or the righteous, is like the shining sun that shines ever brighter unto the perfect day. So I want you to pray that your light will shine brighter and brighter every day in Jesus' name. Say, Father, let my light shine brighter and brighter every day in the name of Jesus. Pray. Father, let our light shine every day brighter and brighter in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, shine your light upon us and let your light shine through us. And let it shine brighter and brighter every day in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Let's look at Psalm 92, verses 1 and 2, and then we'll go to verse 10. Psalm 92, verse 1 says, "It is good to give thanks to the Lord and to sing praises to your name, O Most High, to declare your loving kindness in the morning and your faithfulness every night." That's what we have done in this service. We have praised God. We have glorified his name. We have worshipped him. Now let's go to verse 10. Verse 10 says, "But my horn, you have exalted like a wild ox or like a unicorn. I have been anointed with fresh oil." Oil in the Bible represents the Holy Spirit. When you see anointing with oil, it represents the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. So I want you to pray. Say, "Father, anoint me afresh with your Holy Spirit and with your power. In Jesus' name." Pray. "Father, anoint me afresh with your Holy Spirit and with your power. Father, pour fresh oil upon me. Pour fresh oil upon me in the name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, impart to me power from on high." Say, "Father, impart to me power from on high." Pray. Say, "Father, impart to me power from on high." You need power in this year. Power to stand against the wickedness of the wicked. Power to confront forces of the enemy. Power to face challenges. Power to overcome. And it's God that can release power upon you. The anointing makes all the difference in our lives. The anointing. The yoke is destroyed because of the anointing. The anointing gives you power. Hallelujah. So, Father, anoint us with your Holy Ghost and with your power. Impart to us power from on high. Power to stand for your service. Power to serve you. Power to do your work. Power to enable us to shine brighter and brighter every day. Lord, impart to every one of us power from your throne of grace. Thank you, Lord, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We praise you. We glorify you. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your tender mercies. Thank you, O God, for the abundance of your grace upon us. Thank you for showing us favor. Thank you for being merciful unto us. Lord, we appreciate you. Lord, we love you. Blessed be your holy name, O God, in Jesus' name. Father, as we go, let your presence go with us. Let your presence envelope us. Let your power prevail in our lives. Lord, let your angels encamp round about us. Let them protect us. Let them deliver us. Father, preserve every one of us from all evil this week. I pray that no evil shall befall us. Neither shall any plague come near us in Jesus' name. The sun shall not smite us by day, nor the moon by night. I decree that no weapon fashioned against us shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up in judgment against us, I condemn it in Jesus' name. Every conspiracy against us shall come to nothing in Jesus' name. All they that gather together against us, they shall fall for our sake in the name of Jesus. This week we shall be far from oppression. This week fear shall not come near us. This week, O God, you will order our steps. Father, it shall be well with us. When we sleep, it shall be well with us. When we rise up, it shall be well with us. Father, prosper the work of our hands. I pray that this week we shall not fail. I pray that we shall not falter. I pray we shall not be overcome by the spirit of error in the name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, let us find favor with you this week. Let's find favor with men and women this week in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. I pray for our beloved pastor, Pastor Moyo Akele, and his wife and family. Lord, let it be well with them. bless and prosper them, uphold and strengthen them, and perfect that which concerns them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lord, I plead and apply the blood of Jesus over every one of us, and I pray that the blood will avail for us this week. The blood will speak and answer on our behalf, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. And everybody says, amen. Let's share the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Say to your neighbor, surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Say to another neighbor, surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.